Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans and today we have two new iOS apps that I want to show you. NDI HX Camera and NDI HX Capture. Both are free for a limited time and will help you connect with your audience. So let's dive in and take a look. Alright, so let's start off on my iPhone screen and the first thing that I want to show you is where to download these applications. You don't need to go to our NDI.tv site like you normally would. All you have to do is go to the iOS App Store. And then in your search bar, type in NDI HX. Right? And then these two applications will appear, the NDI HX Capture and NDI HX Camera applications. So these are going to be free for a limited time only. I've already downloaded these, so it doesn't show the price here. But take advantage of that. Now I'm already running NDI HX Capture, so let me go ahead and click Open. So this is how I'm able to capture my screen right now and record it for this video. So when you first start this application, that red dot in the middle is going to be black, and you just click on that, and it will give you a 3-second countdown, and then you are now broadcasting over NDI to anyone who was willing to listen. All right, now, of course, an important note here is you will need to make sure that your TriCaster or whatever NDI-enabled device you're using is connected to the same network as your iPhone to get this to work. All right. Also, we'll go ahead and just minimize this. Another important note is if you have any notifications on for applications like iMessage or Facebook or Instagram, anything that can send you a push notification, go ahead and disable those so you're not interrupted. I've had to re-record this video a couple of times just because I keep getting hammered with different messages from people, etc. But I've turned those all off now so I won't be disturbed. So that application, all it does is it's going to broadcast whatever is on your phone to an NDI-enabled device. It will send the video and audio of whatever application you have open. And to turn it off, all you have to do is either open up that application again and click that red button, or to make it easier, you'll see in the top left corner where my clock is. If I click on my clock, it will now give me a pop-up here saying if you want to stop your broadcast, etc. But I don't because I have some more stuff to show you. So let me go ahead and put my phone down, and now I'm going to move over to my TriCaster interface, and let me show you how to bring that feed in. So we'll go to input number 2. And under my source drop down here, again, these are all the different sources that are broadcasting over NDI, but I want to select Richard's iPhone here and select display, and boom, now I have my phone directly embedded into my TriCaster. So if I want to show a tutorial video on my phone or go through different posts, whatever applications you have, like for example, I can go into my photos here and pull up this video I took of a deer hanging out in my backyard the other day. Now I can just bring it directly into my broadcast. That's pretty awesome. All right, now another way you can use this is also for gaming. So check this out. I'm going to open up Fortnite here, a game that I am terrible at, but this will be a good little example of showing you some things. So now you'll see that I have Fortnite available to me in my input number 2. Now, what it looks a little different. I mean, what is Chapter 2? No, it's Chapter 2. Now, the aspect ratio of your iPhone is a little bit wider than a 16:9 aspect ratio of the session that I currently have my TriCaster in. Now, that doesn't mean that I've necessarily lost it. It just means for this particular input, that's the way it's displayed. So if you are going to be doing an application that has its full range of field here, view, you'll need to go ahead and modify that. So for example, I have input number 2 in my downstream keyer. So I'll go ahead and bring that on screen real quick. So I have a positioner tool on right now, and you'll see that if I turn off my positioning, that will be full screen. But if I turn it on and scale it a little bit, you'll see that I do have the entire feed coming from my iPhone here. So just keep that in mind if you're using this on, say, like a game or something like that. Either go ahead and just throw this particular feed into like a downstream keyer or easily into like a mix effect, for example. That way you can have access to all of the video feed coming off of your phone. Okay, but let me go ahead and close that. I will not be doing any games today. Let's go ahead and show you the next application, which is NDI HX Camera. Now this one is awesome. Check this out. All right, so I'm going to open up NDI HX Camera and check it out. So now you have these that you can use your phone as a wireless NDI camera, which is pretty awesome. So let me go ahead and show you from left to right some of the different settings here. So you'll see if I click on this gear icon in the bottom right, that will bring up a few little additional displays here for you. So on the left here, you have your zoom function. We can go, whoa, there we go. Oh my God, back out. All right, and then also you'll see that there is a brightness feature here as well, which is probably good. I'll look a little bit better that way. Yeah, a lot less bright. All right, you can also turn on the flash on your camera. Now I have this forward facing right now, so you won't be able to see that, but that turns that on. I can also turn on a grid here, so I can line up my shots a little better, put me in the center. That looks like a little bit better of a shot. And then the NDI logo in the middle, if that's blue, that means you're broadcasting. If it turns gray, that means that you're not broadcasting. So you can toggle it on and off that way. And then also you'll see that there's a little microphone icon there that will just basically mute the audio that you're recording off of your microphone. And then, of course, this button here with the camera will allow you to switch your feed around so that you can, you know, use both forward and rear-facing cameras. And then at the bottom here, this other one, this will allow you to change the connection rate that you're going to be broadcasting over NDI. So for example, I have it currently set to high, but I can set it to medium, and then I can also set it to low. All right, so let's go ahead and put that down. So I'll put my phone down over here in my little handy-dandy stand. All right, so we're still viewing this on the NDI capture mode. So let's go ahead and jump over to the TriCaster interface. And in input number 3, I'm going to bring in this feed into my broadcast. So I'll click on input 3 and select from the drop down here, NDI HX camera. And boom, now I have my NDI HX camera coming in. Now it looks like it's flipped right now, but it really isn't. That's because on the NDI HX capture, that's just showing me the native feed from what's going on in the application. And if you look, see my NewTek logo on my shirt here is backwards. But if you bring that into input number 3, for example, now you're getting the correct image and how the aspect ratio should look. Now, another little feature here, if we take a look back on my phone. So right now, if you'll notice, there's a little blue line around my application here. But check this out. If I go through and click on input number 3, which is the output of this camera on my program row, that is going to turn red. So that way you have a little tally light as well, so you know exactly when you're going to be on the air. So as you can see, these applications are extremely powerful. You can use NDI HX Capture to show whatever is on your screen with full video and audio from whatever application you want to run. Also, the NDI HX Camera application will allow you to use the forward and rear-facing cameras of your iPhone and the microphone as well. So you have a cool little NDI camera right here in your pocket. All right. Now, for more videos like this, please visit our YouTube page at youtube.com/NewTek Inc. And for more information on any NewTek products, please talk to your local reseller or go to newtek.com. Until then, thank y'all for watching, and be sure to tune in next time for another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials.